Hello there, my name is Luciano Oliveira. I am a Brazilian attorney who's also licensed in California and Texas. I'm also the managing partner of Oliveira Lawyers, a Brazilian law firm specializing in representing foreign citizens in Brazil. Today, we're going to be talking about the Digital Nomad Visa in Brazil. We're going to be talking about the main questions we hear during our consultations with foreign citizens and that we get by email at our firm, all right? So what is the Digital Nomad Visa in Brazil? It's a visa that is gonna allow you to work and live in Brazil as a digital nomad. It's designed for foreign citizens, of course, and you cannot be working in Brazil. You gotta be working for someone in your country of origin, okay? And it allows you to stay for a year, and it's renewable for a second year. So you can stay up 2 years in Brazil. Who's eligible for this visa? Well, you gotta be a foreign citizen. You have to have a job that allows you to work remotely. You need to provide a proof of income, or you need to provide a proof of funds. If you wanna know the exact amounts, you can check our page on our website. There is a link in the comment section of this video, and you can know exactly the numbers, how much you need per month. It's one option, or how much you need in total in your bank account. You have those two options. Another thing, you need a clean criminal record, right? Like if you have something serious, your application is gonna be denied. In terms of how to apply, there are two options. As long as you have the entire paperwork on point, prepared and ready, including the application, you can basically just go to a Brazilian consulate or embassy in your country of origin, and they are gonna handle the application for you, which is a huge help. If you are in Brazil, you gotta use the migrant web, which is a system that is not designed for end users, so you're probably gonna need to hire someone to apply for you if you are in Brazil, okay? And so again, the main requirements are proof of income, clean criminal record, job that allows you to work remotely. You also need health insurance to cover your period of stay. So if you're applying for the Digital Nomad, it's implied that you wanna stay for a year, so you're gonna need a health insurance to stay in Brazil for a year. And you're also gonna need the passport, but then there is something else many people don't know. You're gonna need a birth certificate if your parents' names, they are not on the passport, which is the case, for instance, for Americans, right? Like a US passport doesn't have the parents' names on it. So an applicant from the US, they are gonna need to present a birth certificate, but it gotta be an original birth certificate, and it gotta be apostilled, and you need to physically send to Brazil, where it gotta be sworn translated, okay? So there are many steps right there, and you can research about it like we describe in details in our website. How long does the Digital Nomad Visa in Brazil last? It lasts for a year. It can be renewed for a second year. Some people, if they are in Brazil, like, you know, once you travel to Brazil, you get a 90-day stay. Sometimes they wanna, you know, stack up those periods of time so they can stay for a 90-day period of time. They apply for an extension of 90 days. And then during this extension, that's when they apply for the Digital Nomad. So in theory, they could stay like 2 years and 180 days, right? Like sometimes people, they don't plan, it's not a well-planned application, and they end up overstaying or, you know, getting their application denied. So we don't usually recommend for you to stack up, you know, those periods of time, but some people, they do it anyhow. Another question we hear, can I bring my family with me to Brazil? Well, you can bring your family, but they cannot have a digital nomad visa as a dependent, right? Like if they also qualify, let's say if you have, I don't know, like your children, they are in their 20s, they work for your company, and you can show, you know, like income, or you can show that they do actually work in your company. In theory, they could get the same visa as well. But if you have like young children and they are not working, they do not qualify for the digital nomad visa, at least as of now. What are the benefits? We have a few videos out there just highlighting the benefits of the digital nomad visa when compared to other visas. But the main benefits are, of course, you can live and work in Brazil. You can access a vibrant culture and diverse community of people. And it's an opportunity to experience life in a new country, right? I think it's something big. For many people, spending time in Brazil as a resident, not like, you know, like in a 1 or 2 week vacation, but actually living in Brazil as a resident is for sure a life-changing experience, okay? What are some of the drawbacks of the digital nomad visa in Brazil? Well, first thing is not a long-term path. So if you're thinking about, you know, permanent residency, or if you're thinking about citizenship, this is not the right visa. There are better visas, okay? There is a high rate of denials, probably because people, they think it's so simple, so basic, they don't need professional help. And then they mess up and get the application denied. Another drawback, we still don't have a waiver in terms of digital nomads becoming a tax resident in the country. So in theory, you could end up having to file taxes in Brazil. This was not decided so far. Not, you know, actually we never heard people discussing that at the government level, but eventually they gotta do so, because I'm sure most digital nomads, they assume, you know, like they're just coming temporarily to the country, they don't need to file taxes. But in our it's not like in the tax code, but customarily accountants, they consider after you've been for 184 days in the country, they're gonna think, you know what, I think you are a tax resident, we should be filing taxes for you, right? So that's another potential drawback. Another question we hear, is it possible to transition from a digital nomad visa to a permanent residency visa? Well, there is no, you cannot stack up time to say, oh, now I'm a permanent resident or I'm gonna become a citizen. It doesn't work for this purpose, but if you are in Brazil for a year or a couple of years, you could find another path to become a permanent resident, right? So it doesn't automatically translate or convert it into something better, but it gives you access to other opportunities. I don't know, maybe you find the love of your life if you're single, and if you marry someone in Brazil, then of course you're gonna acquire a permanent residency, eventually citizenship, but again, it's not automatic, right? So these are some of the advantages, disadvantages, and frequent questions we get here at the firm. If you have a question that is not that wasn't discussed in this video, feel free to enter your question as a comment to the video, and we're gonna do our best to answer your questions. Okay, we hope this information was helpful. If it was, we appreciate if you could like our video, subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching. And see you in the next video.